So now that we know what locality is, let's see how do we use it to improve data accesses. First, we will look at an example that considers borrowing books from the library. In this example, the library represents a data repository that is large, so a lot of data are there, but it is very slow to access. We need to go there, find the book in the building, check it out, bring it back home, and so on. When we're borrowing books from the library, typically there is a lot of temporal locality to it. For example, if we are a student, we might need to look up the definition of locality very often while we're studying. And usually also there is a lot of spatial locality to using books. For example, if we look up some computer architecture definition once, we are likely to be looking up other computer architecture stuff too in the near future. So continuing our library-based locality and data access example, we have seen that the library is large but very slow to access, and that accesses to information in the library have temporal and spatial locality usually. So when a student needs a piece of information from the library, what should he do? Should he go to the library, find the information, read it, and then just go back home? Should he borrow the book, take it home so that future accesses to the information in the book are much faster? Or should he take all the books and then build a library at home? Let's consider each of these three options. If we go to the library every time we need something, we're wasting a lot of time finding the books and then looking up only one piece of information and then returning the book, because we know that there is both temporal and spatial locality, which means we will be probably reading the same book and nearby books very often. So the problem with this approach is that it does not benefit from locality, and this is why typically people do not use it when they need to study a topic and use library resources. If we go to the library and borrow the book, we bring it home, and now we have the book on the topic that we are currently working on close to us. So this is an approach that does exploit temporal and spatial locality and eliminates the problem of the library being large and slow, because we have very few books borrowed at home, so we can quickly find what we need in them. This is why most people will use this option. The approach of taking all the books and building a library at home is very expensive and also provides very little benefit. Yes, it saves us the trip to the library and back, but it doesn't save us the time of searching among many books, finding them on the shelves, and so on. So really, we'd rather have relatively few books that we are currently interested in than have many books and have to look them up very slowly. So just like people, when faced with these choices about the library, usually choose the second option because it's a good trade-off between being able to find information quickly and not being overwhelmed with the quantity of information that we have brought in. When we have a processor that needs to access main memory, we will use the same approach. Instead of going to memory for every single memory location, we will bring the content of memory locations that we are interested in closer to us, but we will try not to bring too much close to us, because that will result in a very slow structure close to us, so we will again have slow accesses. So what we want is something small that keeps only the information we are really interested in. And that small repository of information is called a cache when we are talking about memory accesses.